Hello guys, in this tutorial we are going to make this amazing isometric room in Blender, which is very easy to make and can be created by absolute beginners. So let's get started. So with the default cube selected, go to edit mode, select any one vertices and press delete vertices, and you will see isometric room. And now go to object mode and scale it up a bit. So now it's looking pretty cool. So now let's add a TV. Making a TV, it's pretty simple. Just place your 3D cursor here, add mesh cube and give it a size of TV. Yeah, perfect. Now go to edit mode and select this front face. Go to face select mode, select this front face, and now insert this face, and now extrude inwards somewhere around here. Yeah, fine. So now let's make a table for TV. So place your 3D cursor here, press shift and right click to place 3D cursor, add mesh cube, and now resize it. And now go to edit mode, add some loop cuts. So one here, one above here, and two here, and the last one at the bottom. And now go to face select mode and select both of these faces and extrude them inwards. And now add a bevel modifier so that it will look a bit smooth. Extend the segments to 2, and now it's looking pretty good. Now let's add our couch. So place your 3D cursor here, add a mesh cube, and now scale it so that it feels perfect. And now just add a subdivision surface modifier and set the levels to 2. Go to edit mode, add a few edge loops. Okay, fine. So now go to object mode and again add a cube here. Let's add a cube here, add mesh cube and scale it down. Make it a bit thinner. Yeah, that's look perfect. And now scale it down on the z-axis. Yeah, fine. Now scale it on the y-axis across our couch. Yeah, perfect. Now add a subdivision surface modifier, set the levels to 2. Now go to edit mode, add 2 edge loops. Fine. Now go to face select mode, select this face and extrude it out. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. So now go to object mode and shade it smooth. Yeah, now it's looking perfect. Let's add another table. So add here cube, add mesh cube, scale it down and scale it especially on the z axis. Now go to edit mode and add 2 edge loops on the corners. And now go to face select mode and extrude both of these faces a bit forward and scale it on the y-axis a little bit. Yeah, and add a bevel modifier. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. And now just add mesh, and I'm going to add a cylinder, scale it on the z-axis. Yeah, right here. Okay, so now let's add a window. So go to object, select our cube, go to edit mode, add few edge loops, select this face, extrude it out a bit and just delete faces. And now let's add a window. So now go to edit, preferences, add-ons and search Archipack and just turn on that add-on. Go to Archipack, add a window, and I'm going to use this flat 3 window. So now by using these arrows you can manipulate them. And now go to rendered view and set the renderer to cycles and select this window, and under the window glass click on the use nodes and just bump up the transmission value and reduce the roughness value. And now you can see it's transparent. Delete our default light, select our cube, go to edit mode, and select with the front face selected of the screen, add a new, again add assign new, and go to emission and bump it up and change the emission strength to around 50. No, not 50, around 20. Yeah, 20 looks fine. 20 looks fine. So now go to object mode and let's add an wooden texture to our tables. Now go to shading tab, add new, and add a wave texture and a color ramp. Yeah. So plug the factor into factor and color into the color. And now you will see some waves on our texture. Now what I'm going to do, just give it some distortion, yeah, somewhere around 17, and scale it around 20. Yeah, 20 looks fine. So now go to bump up this detail, and yeah, now it's looking pretty good. So now on the color ramp, change the black color to brown, and this color to a wood color. Just play with it until you found a pretty good result. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. Select this table and assign it the same material. Yeah, and now select our couch and add a new material. Set the base color to black, decrease the roughness value a bit, and now assign the same material to the whole couch. And now it's looking pretty good. So now let's go to rendered view. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. So select our cylinder and add a red material. I think it's below our room, so yeah. So now let's add some speakers. Add mesh cube and scale them down. And now add a bevel modifier. Set the segments to 2. Now go to edit mode, add some edge loops to make the faces of the speaker. And now go to face select mode, select both of these faces and extrude them inwards. Yeah, perfect. Now go to shading tab, go to edit mode with both of these faces selected. Go to materials, add a new material, assign, and I'll give them a little bit grayish color. And to the whole cube, I will assign them a black color with roughness. Yeah, now it's looking good. Let's go to rendered view. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. So shift D on the y-axis to duplicate. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. Let's add some material to our room. So go to the cube selected, go to edit mode and add some edge loop. Yeah, now I have added some edge loops. So now I'm going to select some faces. With these faces selected, go to materials tab, add a new material, assign them and make it black. And now it will look like this. I think I should remove this carpet. It's looking way off. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. So select our TV and add in a black material. Yeah, so with this window selected, add a black material. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. Now let's set up our camera. But first go to rendered view, turn on adaptive sampling and denoising, turn on both of them. I'm using CPU, so I'm going to use open image denoise, but if you're using GPU, you should use the optics. And then go to color management and set the look to high contrast. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. Play the exposure value, 1 is fine. Yeah, 1 is looking pretty good. So now I'm going to add a plane and scale it all the way up. And now let's set up our camera. So with the camera selected, go to camera and set the type to orthographic. Now play with the orthographic value. Now let's go to rendered view. Yeah, now it's looking pretty good. So I'm going to change the material of this plane to black. And now just go to rendered view under performance set your favorable tile size and just then hit F12 to render, and that's pretty much it. If you like this video, hit that like button and consider subscribing for more great content. Have a nice day. Goodbye.